are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe our channel and do not forget to press bell icon so that you'll get all our future videos as notification. And today we are going to see how to dismantle, put on all the checks, how to assemble and build a pump. So build a pump is basically air operated pump. So I will inform you, I will give the maximum information about how we need to open, what are all the things that we need to check, and how we need to assemble the welded pump. Please continue watching the video. We will go and check the video now. Okay, this is our welded pump. We are going to dismantle the pump because the pump is not performing well. Is losing its suction. So before dismantling the pump, I just want to tell you regarding the parts of the pump. This is a Wilton pump. It is air operated pump. And this is the pump casing. And always for a Wilton pump, bottom side will be the inlet suction side. And the top side will be the discharge pad. And this is the air supply from where the diaphragm or the pump is getting operated. So this is your air piston chamber. It got two pistons inside this. I will open and I will show you what are all the checks that we need to do when we are opening this air piston chamber. And we got four clamps for top and bottom foot. This is your bottom foot and this is your top foot. That means suction foot and discharge foot. And main advantage of this pump is it can make suction of any kind of liquid. And only difference is if your diaphragm material is different, then you have some temperature regulations. Accordingly, you can select your diaphragm, but if you want to transfer any hot liquid, your diaphragm should match for it. So there is no much complication in this pump. So I will open the pump, I will show you what are all the things that we need to check and how we are going to dismantle, we'll see. Okay, first I will dismantle the discharge part. Only clamp, you just you are removing the clamp and you can remove the discharge foot. So this is the clamp and you have to secure it properly. You should not miss any of the spares. I open the other side. On both the clamps. So this is your discharge pipe. You can see, to open it, this is your discharge pipe. And this is your valve. This is these two are the main important part of this pump. So you have to keep this very carefully. And when you open this valve for inspection, you have to check for any damages or something. There is no damage, it's all clean. And this ball valve acts like a non-return valve. So I keep this. Now I open the body. The sir. The main thing is you should not miss out any spares. I open the suction side. Now we remove the clamp for the suction side also, and I remove the chamber. So you can see there is two valve bell, two in the suction side and two on the discharge side. So this valve bell acts like a non-return valve. So this condition of the valve should be very good. If not, you will find a drop in efficiency of your pump. So now we open the other side. This is the cover for your diaphragm. So this is your pump. You can see, yeah, see, this is the reason why our pump lost its efficiency and it is not taking suction, because the diaphragm is already damaged. Earlier someone must have repaired it. So we will change the, yeah, see, you can see there is a hose, here is a hole in the diaphragm. This diaphragm is actually acts like a pump. Okay, we will remove this diaphragm and we will change the diaphragm. So here, this is already damaged, and this diaphragm, yeah, it is good, no problem. You can see there is no damage of anything, there is no defect, nothing, it is good only. So I will change this diaphragm. So for changing the diaphragm, very easy. All you need to unscrew the cover. Yeah, this is your nut actually. You see, when you see this, you have to check for the thread. Thread is good. And you open the, this is your diaphragm. See, someone had already repaired this. They must have run this for some time, but now it is almost gone, because you can see a hole over here. So see, when the, if this is not okay, your pump won't perform well. So I will change the diaphragm. You should see the thread also. Thread should be in a good condition, and this is your diaphragm case. You can bring this out. So what happens is, I'll just tell you how this pump works. So what happens when air is coming from this way, this will push, two pistons will be there inside. There will be a two piston inside, I will show you later. So whichever piston is pushing towards this, suppose your diaphragm will be in this way. In this way, if the diaphragm is getting sucked, like mean in this manner, that means it is taking suction. And when this is inside, this will, the other side will go like this. That means this, when it takes suction, it will be, the diaphragm position will be like this. And when this is suction, and this chamber will be a discharge side. So it is very simple. Whenever you find any problem in suction discharge, all you need to just open your solenoid, this air operated piston, lubricate it, and maybe you can find some damage in the piston o-ring, change it and put it back. It will work very nicely. See, yeah, I removed the shaft. This is your shaft for your diaphragm. You can see the shaft is in a good condition only. Shaft is in a good condition, threads are in a good condition. Okay, now I will box back. You can see the o-rings inside. These are all the o-rings. So o-rings are also in a very good condition. So what I do is, you have to just lubricate the o-ring area. The o-rings looks good, there is no damage. I'll just lubricate it. Just lubricate on both the side. Okay. Okay. Lubricate the shaft. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I will replace this with a new diaphragm. Yeah, this is a new diaphragm. You can see Wilden pump, the air side. This is your air side. You have to be very sure that we are keeping this direction in a correct way. You cannot put upside down like this. You have to put this in a proper way. Okay, and you can see the difference between the old and the new one. Old and new one. Okay, so I'm going to box back. This one, the inside. You have to match this air side. Air side should be always inside. So I'll put this. Always ensure you have to put some anti-seizure in your any kind of bolts whichever you are doing work with it. So you can see this, this groove should match with this groove. Movement should be free. One. That means your lubrication is proper and your movement for your diaphragm is okay. There is no restriction in movement. So this is one check that you need to do when you are boxing up. It should not be restricted anywhere. Done. See, after tightening, you can see the movement of our piston is okay. So the main thing is you have to lubricate the shaft space area. So if your o-ring is good and it is well lubricated, then there won't be any problem in this kind of pump. Okay. I will box it up now. So before boxing up, all you need to check is your condition of this foot. You can see there is no sludge, nothing, it is clean. Still I will clean it. Clean it nicely. Check the condition of your valve. It is good. And this seat should also be in a good condition because it will act like a ceiling. When the pump is taking suction, it will come up
the water will flow in. When the discharge is happening, it will go down and it will act like a ceiling. So in this kind of pump, both the side you will get suction and discharge action. So that is the special thing in this pump. Okay, now I'm going to box up. Okay, both the balls, you can see both are in good condition. Bring back and assembling procedure for this pump is very easy. Just you need to clamp it. Whichever clamp you removed, you just put the clamp back in position. That's all. You are done with your job. Tighten the first clamp. You have to inspect the body casing also. There should not be any damage in this body. Back the unit in place and you have to clamp it. So, 1 minute. So, ensure when you are putting back the clamp, you are not damaging the side surface of your diaphragm. So you can see here, you can see the clamp is perfectly holding the diaphragm and the body. So now I'll fit back the other side. So again, this condition should be checked. It is already checked, it is in a good condition. I put back and back the foot clamp first. Whenever you are tightening this bolt is a special bolt. It's a you can see a cut over here and there is a slot in your clamp also. So whenever you are fixing this bolt, you have to ensure this slot is going inside. You can see here. So it doesn't tend to turn when you are tightening. So you have to keep this in mind. Okay. So fixing of bottom clamp is done. You can see both the clamp are in intact, in place, and now we'll put back the one more remaining clamp over here for the body.
your diaphragm chamber.
All clamps are in place, body clamp, foot clamp. Now only remaining is your discharge side, so we will fix that also. So again same, inspected already, put back in place, and this discharge side, keep it here. So put back the clamp. Done with our dismantling and assembling of our Wilden Pumper. Okay, I believe they would like this information given by me. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.